Blessings, beloved ones. This is Amanda Amethyst, and I'm bringing you a lunar taroscope for the time period between the full moon in Scorpio on April 21st or 22nd, depending on where you are, and the new moon in Taurus on May 6th, 2016. I hope that you're all having a wonderful April so far, and that those good times will continue to roll. This time period includes a lot of other interesting events that will be happening. So we already have several planets that are retrograde, and Mercury will be going retrograde also during this time. We've also got both the lunar and solar Beltane, and those are super powerful times of the year. Some of you may already be familiar with Beltane and some may not. Just extremely briefly, because there's so much information out there about Beltane that I'm sure you can find it on your own with the use of the internet or books or the library or whatever it is that you like to do your research with. Beltane is a really wonderful, fun, powerful, expressive time. It's sort of an ecstatic expression of uniting the masculine and the feminine, both within and without. So there's a lot of celebration. It's often a time to connect with community, and it's a place and time where our fertility and our sexual and creative energy can really be expressed and acknowledged. So it's a really fun time of year and a really healing time of year too. It's a beautiful, beautiful time. So feel free to do more of your own research into that. So we're going to be talking about the time period between the full moon in Scorpio, which is super deep, primal, sexual, mystical energy. And this time period, the full moon in Scorpio, is your deep inner world coming up to the surface. So that can be really exciting, or that can be really kind of like an oh no moment where all of these things come up. So this is a time to really accept all the parts of yourself and all of the parts of others. So when things come up, particularly with our sexuality, when things come up with our deeply held beliefs and understandings of the world, a lot of times it can feel like this is coming up in opposition to or because of other people in our lives. But really what this time period is about and why we're having those types of interactions, which can seem like kind of like bumping up against other people, is that it's bringing it up for you to really become aware of your own beliefs, your own thoughts, and your own feelings, and to accept these in yourself. This is a time when you can heal whatever you feel needs to be healed, and also to allow what is, and to allow what has been. This is a beautiful time of challenging yourself to new depths, and also a time of growth. So growing within during this full moon in Scorpio, so that we can then grow without, which is more of Taurus new moon energy. So the Taurus new moon, this is a very grounding energy, whereas the Scorpio full moon is deep, they're both deep. The Scorpio full moon is deeply in the esoteric, and the Taurus new moon is deeply in this physical reality and how we're going to create our lives in this physical reality, our homes, our jobs, our families and friends, our relationships. What is this new reality that you are wishing to create? This is a great time to really take a look at that. What life are you creating for yourself, and what types of habits or actions do you need to create in your life in order to bring about this reality that you want and deserve? what world are you creating for yourself? So this has a lot of the, to me, in the tarot, the Emperor energy. This has a lot of that energy in it. So this creating a foundation, a stable foundation, and being able to hold all of that space for others and for yourself to thrive in. So in this time period in between the full moon in Scorpio and the new moon in Taurus, this is really a time where a lot of the deep spiritual work that many of us have been doing just continues. This is a time of shadow work and addressing, and that means just addressing aspects of yourself that have been repressed or aspects of yourself that you have not yet dealt with. Things that we consider to be dark or in the shadows, deep down in there. So what Scorpio is all about, all those things that are deep down in there. So this time period is moving fully into and through the darkness to reach the light. And this will bring us a deeper knowingness, which is also what Scorpio is all about, this deep knowing of the what's called the occult. So a deep knowing of that which is not tangible, seen, or touched, but that which is and exists. So this is a time period of a deep knowingness of the darkness, of the mother, of the goddess CJ. She is the void from which all life emerges, and that void, that darkness in which all light shines. Darkness is not a bad thing. Sometimes we refer to our darkness or the darkness of others as a negative thing, but that's really a very limited view. It's a very limited thought. Yes, you are the light, and yes, you are the darkness. You are the all-encompassing darkness, the matrix. So many of us have a negative idea of the word matrix now, especially since, well, really, since the Matrix series of movies has come out, we view the matrix as something that we need to unplug from and disconnect from. I'd like to introduce the idea that we re-examine that belief. The origin of the word matrix, the meaning of the word is something that constitutes the place or point from which something else originates. So in the case of CJ, the cosmic womb, darkness, that is the origin point for all that is. And matrix also, it derives from the word mater for mother. So it's a feminine source point for other things that exist. So I'd like to invite you to re-examine your thoughts of the word matrix and your use of that word and your understanding of what the matrix is. So in my opinion, yes, we do want to disconnect from the control that many of us are born into. And we can do that by going even deeper into the actual matrix, into the darkness, into the cosmic womb. This is a really big concept. This is a very big, it's not even a thing. This void is so big. The magnitude is far greater than you have perhaps understood before. Your magnitude is far greater than that which you may have understood before. Embrace your darkness, for it is the foundation, the matrix within which your light shines. I find it to be ironic that the twisting of this word matrix is one of it's really a last-ditch effort by patriarchal powers that be to control mass thinking and influence it negatively against the feminine. We are moving into an age of enlightenment and of balance between the feminine and the masculine. This twisting and this pushing away of the matrix is a perfect example of the energy during this time period between the full moon in Scorpio and the new moon in Taurus, in my opinion. So right now we're being asked to examine our thoughts, examine our beliefs, examine our actions, to see through our conditioning to the deeper truths which lie below all of these things which we've been conditioned to believe and to be. So dive into your darkness. Do not reject it out of fear of the unknown. This is where breakthroughs and aha moments are found during this cycle. So it's a very powerful time, and this can feel like a big challenge. This can feel like, often when we're changing, it can feel scary because there's an element of unknown, there's an element of losing something. And we're never losing anything. We're just shifting, we're transforming. So we can feel gratitude for that which we're shifting out of, which has served us in the past. Okay. So I'll be, for the reading, I'll be using the fifth tarot, which is a deck by Teresina and Martine Bakkens. And I'll also be using the Crystal Ally Oracle cards by Naisha Aishan. And also potentially a card from the Goddess Guidance Oracle deck by Doreen Virtue and the Angels of Atlantis deck by, which is another Oracle deck by Stuart Pierce. So while I was preparing for the video, a card from the Crystal Ally Oracle deck has already made itself known to us, and it is the card Dioptes, Forgiveness. So this card is in the water suit, and it features the crystal Dioptes. And this is a really beautiful image. It has a feminine figure and a masculine figure looking at and reaching out to connect with each other. And it's a really beautiful idea of forgiveness and allowing ourselves to forgive ourselves first and foremost, forgiving ourselves for sometimes even for coming here, for being here, because it can feel very overwhelming sometimes. We feel things here. We experience the whole gamut here. And sometimes it doesn't feel good or feel positive, but it is what we chose. So allowing ourselves forgiveness for being here, allowing ourselves this beautiful gift of forgiveness for our past beliefs, our past actions towards ourselves and towards others, and also extending this forgiveness to others as well for what we believe to be wrongdoings, which they have offenses which have been committed against us. So we can use, you may wish to look into more information about Ho'oponopono, which is an ancient tradition being reintroduced to the rest of the world through the Hawaiian culture. It's a practice of forgiveness, which also brings us back to the community theme. The community is a big theme right now. So individual integrity and authenticity, and then also bringing that to the community, whatever your community is. Perhaps it's a physical, literal community in your area, or perhaps it's your online community, your soul family, however it is that you connect with community. And if you don't feel connected with community, please do reach out online, because there are a lot of groups for all different sorts of people and beings to connect in community and in support. Okay. So with the fifth tarot deck, asking for guidance for all those who will see this video during the time period between the full moon in Scorpio and the new moon in Taurus 2016, April to May. First card which we received is a major arcana card, also the water suit, the moon. Card number 18, the moon. Perfect for the full moon in Scorpio, really. This card has a depth, a quality of depth to it. The moon card is a point in our lives when we are comfortable to dive into those depths, and when we have an understanding of ourselves through and through. And when we have this understanding of ourselves through and through, then we can express more compassion towards the other beings that we interact with in this world. I get a really strong sense of a feeling of compassion and a feeling, there's almost a sorrow to this. So if you're having a depth of feelings and it's painful emotions, or if you feel like you're getting caught up in the past or swept up in these thoughts and beliefs, allow yourself to fully feel things, but make the decision to not dwell longer than necessary in these places, which may feel a little bit painful. Dwelling in that feeling Dwelling in those feelings longer than necessary can create a cyclical effect. It can make us feel like we're locked in a cycle of always having to feel this way. Sometimes that's just where we're at, and that's okay. But we can also choose to move on by taking actions. So we can act. And again, I want to stress feeling your emotions fully. So it's not that you're trying to avoid the feelings in general. Like, you're not trying to avoid having these emotions or denying that they exist. This is allowing yourself to feel that richness, that depth of emotion, that depth of understanding and thought, and to move on when it's time to move on, and to add these feelings and these experiences to your arsenal of tools to help others. And so if you know somebody who's going through a really hard time right now, if you feel that you have the extra energy to share with them, just reach out to them, let them know that you're there. If you've experienced something similar, you may just wish to say that you've had a similar experience and you're there for them. You don't need to go into detail. You don't need to tell them that you know exactly what they're going through, but if you express some solidarity with them, this can be very helpful right now. Allowing yourself to be as you are and to be in your natural rhythm and your natural cycles, because here we see the moon, we also see the ocean. The moon has that power of sway on the ocean. The moon controls the tides. And so allowing for ourselves to experience the natural rhythms, which we all go through, of different experiences in life, different emotions, different ways of being, having varying amounts of energy. Just allow yourself to go through these cycles because they are natural and they are in your highest good for growth in this lifetime. This card also has fairies on it, water spirits. So really getting out there and connecting with bodies of water, connecting with nature to cleanse yourself, to come back to yourself, cleansing away all of the extra debris that may be building up that you may be carrying around with you, washing all of that away so that you can come back to your authentic self, to your deepest form of yourself. The other card which we got for this reading is the Five of Lotus, shape-shifting. The Lotus suit has to do, it's the soul suit, the soul essence suit. So this card is recognizing our abilities to shape-shift, recognizing all of the different roles which we play and our ability to shift in between these roles, to play a different part, so to speak, in our own lives, in the lives of others, and in this world and in other worlds. So you can see this being has the ability to shift into several different forms. So this card is a reminder to all of us that we all have this ability to shapeshift. Whether or not you believe that to be physically shifting into different beings or shifting between the roles that you play, this card is also knowing when it's appropriate to be in a different role. So when is it time for us to focus on and be a friend or a mother or a fill in the blank, whatever roles you play? When is it time for us to play the role of healer? And when is it time for us to play the role of friend who's listening and not taking action other than just listening, just being there for somebody, for example? So a lot of change in this. It's a five, transformation, and it is the card of change, shape-shifting. Being comfortable in change. Many of us fear change. Many of us don't feel comfortable making changes in our lives, again, because of that fear that we're going to lose something. There's nothing to be lost. You're safe, and it's safe for you to break out of your cocoon. There's a butterfly. This card. So it's safe for you to break out of your limiting cocoon and spread your wings and fly. I'm going to also pull a card from the Angels of Atlantis Oracle by Stuart Pierce. And this is a beautiful deck. It's a sound healing deck. It's a deck that works with the angels. So with this, we're just asking for angelic guidance for this period of time. And the card which came up for us is the Archangel Gabriel, Balance. In this deck, the angels are depicted as orbs. So this blue orb is the Archangel Gabriel, and this card is Balance. It shows us the Leonardo da Vinci man spread out, some sacred geometry. Balance. This card also, the forgiveness card, is also reminding me of balance. So this Angel Gabriel card, Balance, is really asking us to, is reminding us, reminding us that we can come to balance in this life, and asking us, how are we doing this? How are we, where are we pushing ourselves too much? And where are we not pushing ourselves enough? Where can we shift? Do we need to shift to come into balance? Are you already in balance? If you're already in balance, this is a confirmation card for you that the changes that you've made and the actions that you've been taking are right on point. So good job. For those of you who feel that you are not in balance, this is a really nice gentle reminder from the angels that balance is within your reach. Just go within to your center point, into your heart, and feel, where is that balance point? Where is that center point? And is there anything in your life which distracts you from being in this place of balance? So these cards are sound healing cards as well. So I'm going to look and see what our sound is. Gabriel, the divine messenger, balance. Om Mani Padme Hum, chanted 3 times, will rebalance your process as this mantra opens up compassionate yielding in our hearts. So, chanting Om Mani Padme Hum 3 times to rebalance our processes and open compassionate yielding in our hearts. So I'll end with the chanting of Om Mani Padme Hum 3 times, and I invite you to join me in that chanting. Thank you so much for joining me for this Lunar Taroscope. I hope that it is beneficial for you. If you feel that it is, I really appreciate any likes, comments, and shares that you'd like to send my way. This has also been a general reading for all of us who will see this video during this time. And if you see this video not within this time period, this information is still relevant to you. We become aware of things because they're relevant to us in some way. If you're interested in a personal reading, you can contact me at nectarofthegoddesstemple@gmail.com. I've also got a website that will be up and running soon. Yay. And I'm also on Facebook as Amanda Amethyst, so you can feel free to reach out to me. And we've been talking a lot about community in the last several readings. So if you're interested, if you're looking for your community, your soul family, and you feel a resonance with me, I invite you to reach out to me through a message or an email, and let's connect and keep on going together. Okay, thank you so much. Let's all, if you'd like to join me, you're welcome to join me. I'm going to put my attention on the blue ray and the Archangel Gabriel, or Gabriel, however you'd like to say it. And also on my heart. And we'll chant Om Mani Padme Hum 3 times. Okay. Om Mani Padme Hum. Om Mani Padme Hum. Om Mani Padme Hum. Thank you so much. Have a wonderful moon cycle. Many blessings to you.